My name is Hervé Jaubert. I'm a former Navy officer and a former covert operative for the French Secret Service.
Jaubert came to Dubai to develop recreational submarines for tourists and rich Emiratis. He soon found himself hobnobbing with Dubai's finest, including its feudal ruler, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum. But when the company went under, his investors demanded nearly $1 million in compensation.
To me, it was like a dream. I saw it as a huge opportunity to mass product my submarine for the tourist industry and recreational use. Everything changed shortly after that, and I had to make another plan.
Jaubert says he got his family out of the country, then decided to rely on his intelligence skills to escape.
The night before, I was able to put 20 miles from my exit point to the police boat, but there was one boat that was 3 miles close to my point of exit, and I had to make sure that this boat would not be able to chase me the next day when I would be on a rubber boat on the water. So my plan was to get in the water, swim at night, get inside the Coast Guard station and neutralize that boat.
A woman in the Middle East in the black burqa is nothing but the shadow of their life. They do not exist. They don't talk to you. So if you dress like them, nobody's going to look at you, to talk to you, even the police.
He donned an abaya worn by Emirati women to sneak onto and disable a Navy patrol boat.
I could go around and undetected, totally undetected.
I was very calm, very confident. To me, I knew that I was on the eve of getting out of this country, and I really felt comfortable because I was in my element. This is my element, I know all that. So once I was under the control, I had fear because I would not control anything. But from there, I was very happy. And I come back on the beach, I knew that boat would not go anywhere. I had clogged the fuel lines, so that if they needed to run the boat, the next day the engine would not stop. And it would take at least a week for them to figure it out. But by then I would be far. But it was nice.
Jaubert made a deal with Dubai World, an international conglomerate, to build the subs in the Persian Gulf. But after a year, what he says was a business dispute turned sinister.
Jaubert escaped by boat before he was arrested for debts he claimed he never owed.
The problem seems to be that the money that they were putting in the company came from other projects, and of course that doesn't work. They just pulled the plug and started to put the blame on me. So I was questioned by the police. It was quite intense. Multiple interrogations, and they were trying to get confessions for me, all in Arabic. They wanted me to sign paper that I did not understand what it meant, and I denied everything. I mean, from the start, they wanted to make me look like I was a bad guy. So because it did not work, the third time I went to the police, this time they threatened me that I would be tortured, put away in a cave, 300 meters down in a cave. They would insert needles in my nose, things like that. I was scared, and at that time, I understood it was over. And I had to plan for an emergency exit, if you want. But I had to do it in a smart way, because in Dubai, if they think that you are not playing their games, they're going to put you in jail. They don't need the probable cause, they don't need anything. They just put you in jail without charge, and they can keep you there forever.
Then he sailed out to sea in a small dinghy to a yacht that was waiting to spirit him away.
After about 6 hours, I spotted the boat, and we met in international waters out of the UAE jurisdiction. I climbed on the sailboat, greeted my friend, and we sailed to India with a glass of Grand Marnier. I managed to sneak on the sailboat. The feeling at the time was a tremendous feeling of freedom. I had been under pressure, fear, for almost a year, and now being on the boat, going away, that was, I will never forget that.
After a nervous 10 days at sea, he reached India safely and has now written a book called Escape from Dubai.
When Dubai World learned that I had escaped and I was publishing a book, then they took me to court in Dubai. Then I took them to court for the defamation and the fraud. And then they took me back to court. So now all those lawsuits are consolidated in the US. It's like having your life on hold. Eventually, I'm very positive on the outcomes of that trial. But I just have to deal with it on a daily, day-to-day basis. Hello.